Hello Internet and welcome to Ever Wonder Perspectives. 1000 years at a crucial point in human history. 3500 to 2500 BCE. A time that is as far away from the founding of the city of Rome as Rome is from us. We start in the year 3500 BCE. The world is still in the Neolithic era, or in other words, the Stone Age. During that time, the inhabitants of England start constructing what is now called Stonehenge. But back then, it is rather more of a relatively simple hill with wooden poles. Meanwhile, on the other side of Europe, in the Caucasian steppes, the locals succeed in domesticating and using horses over the next few centuries. The result of this accomplishment will change the world forever. But all of this goes unnoticed by the people of Central Egypt, since they are busy building the first zoo of the world. Something that wasn't invented by the Chinese for a change. But since there is nothing yet that could be called China, that isn't too surprising. Instead, China was split into many different tribes. And the first dynasty will still take about 1300 more years to emerge. And all of this happens while the mammoths are still alive in parts of northeastern Siberia. In fact, over the whole time span of these 1000 years, they will stay alive and only go extinct around 1650 BCE on the small Wrangel Island. At the same time when the fresco of Aquaterium was made. But back to our time span. Let's leave 3500 BCE behind and jump 200 years forward to 3300. In the Fertile Crescent, the usage of bronze starts to spread, initiating the Bronze Age. But it will take centuries to replace the Stone Age in the various parts of Eurasia. Along with bronze, the cuneiform script and hieroglyphs are developed in the Middle East and Egypt. Now being able to document information, higher civilizations can finally form, such as the Egyptian culture. After this, it only took about 100 years for those civilizations to develop, implement and use a simple numeric writing system. Something that isn't heard of in Europe, where one of the most intriguing and well-known murder cases took place in the Alps at the Austrian-Italian border. A man in his 40s was chased and shot down by an arrow. He eventually died, was covered and mummified by a glacier. Today, he is known as Ötzi the Iceman. Remember, we are still around the year 3200 BCE. Around a time when the first pharaohs are starting to rule. Over the next century, we will leave Eurasia and look at the new world. In the year 3114 BCE, the 13th baktun of the Mayan calendar begins and with it day zero of their creation myth. We will stay in the 13th baktun until the year 2012, when the world is definitely going to end because the internet said so. Or, since we are already in 2017, we just switch over to the next baktun. Another thing that happens during that time is the sprouting of the oldest individual trees still alive in today's United States, California. Methuselah and a secret, even older one. 100 years later, at the start of the 3rd millennium BCE, people start to migrate over Alaska to settle in Greenland during the next 500 years. They won't endure, but this will be the first time for humans to set foot on this immense island. Another first for humanity is the successful domestication of the llama in South America, the goose in Egypt and the silkworm in China. All of this happens while today's Romania and the western parts of China first encounter the special effects of cannabis. At least, these are the findings. This whole smoking crescent was probably a little high at the time. So we better jump 200 years further. The year 2800 BCE. Along the Indus River, the Indus Valley civilization emerges. A culture that had great knowledge in architecture and urban planning. They lived in wide parts of today's Pakistan, India and Afghanistan and started to prioritize cities over small villages. There could be a whole video just about this civilization. In the Fertile Crescent, on the other hand, one of the first great persons we know about ruled, Gilgamesh. Sometime later, one of the oldest and most famous epic poems would be created in his name, although likely with rather few facts in common with the real person. From here, we will jump forward about 300 years to our end date of 2500 BCE. One millennium after the first efforts on Stonehenge started without stones, the people tried to improve the concept and finally start to build the Stonehenge we know and love today. But this isn't the only great building in progress. Still in the Old Kingdom, centuries before rulers like Ramses II or Tutankhamun, the current pharaoh began the construction of the Pyramids of Giza, the lone survivor of the seven wonders of the ancient world. Why our migrants from Alaska finally set their foot for the first time on Greenland. This concludes our 1000 year trip to one of the most important eras in human history. But remember, we achieved all of this while large parts of Europe were still in the Stone Age, mammoths won't go extinct for another 900 years, and Proto-China was still 300 years in the future. And with that being said, thanks for watching. Have a good one.